world was very much not being accessed, except by polar explorers and the odd scientists. And so that's very much what we wanted to change. And we started a spectacularly ill-planned business with a few tents, and we just thought if we build the camp, maybe somebody will come to it. We've got 18 different nationalities, which is fabulous and often quite confusing. Thank God English is the predominant language, because I sort of act as translator often between sort of a Russian mechanic talking to an Australian guy about the runway with a French high mountain guide, and it's usually kind of chaotic. But nicely representative of Antarctica. You know, no one owns Antarctica, and the fact that we're like the multi, you know, the world nations is really, really fun. So every time we do a landing, poor Beatrice has to update the presentation, but we're now up to about 140 landings, which is fantastic. The Airbus we're using today is, we've done probably about 20, 25 landings with this aircraft now. So yeah, it's this is really where it all started. So this is raw ice that we're using, but then we treat it with basically these machines that plow the runway, very, very not microscopic, sort of like an inch plowing furrows that we put on the runway, and this creates the friction. So there's this whole balance between the temperature, because we need -6 or below for the temperature to set the ice properly for the friction, and we can achieve frictions that are basically equivalent to landing on Cape Town International on a wet day. So we get incredible frictions, but it all needs to sort of, the stars need to align. So that's why our plan is to bring the flight forward. I don't know whether any of you guys know this yet, but what we want to do is we want to depart this afternoon or this evening. And the reason being is because we've got some decent cold temperatures, and then we've got some lower cloud that's coming in tomorrow about 6 Zulu. So we want to get ahead of some low cloud. It's not a big storm, it's nothing to worry about in terms of the guys that are staying at Echo or staying at Wolfsbank. It's not like we've got a big blizzard coming in, it's just not perfect aviation conditions. So we're going to bring the flight forward to tonight, and the idea is to leave at 6 p.m. local time tonight. But essentially one of the key factors of this is that it's got return range. So we can fly all the way to Wolfsbank, we can circle for 3 to 4 hours, and then we can fly all the way back again in terms of our fuel. So it's a really safe option. We've also got 4 engines, love a lot of engines, always a nice thing. And then there's plenty of space on board the aircraft to get changed. And about 45 minutes before we land, we'll ask the pilots to turn the temperature down as low as it goes, which is not very low, it's like, sort of like 15 degrees or something. And then we'll all start to get changed into our polar gear. We're going to be served food on board the plane as well, so you will definitely eat on board the plane. So then we all get changed, and what I tend to do is wear my thermal layers, my Gore-Tex, and my boots, and then on my top, just a thermal layer of fleece, and then I just keep my sort of outer stuff, the Gore-Tex, the hats, the gloves, all of that sort of stuff, my sunglasses on my lap. Otherwise, you tend to get really, really hot because you wear all your clothes, and then we still got to land, it's another 30 minutes and all that sort of stuff. So try not to get hot and sweaty, just simply because as we exit the aircraft, what tends to happen, people put on all their clothes, they're really hot, they steam up, and then they've basically got to go down really steep steps onto the ice. So just kind of keep your, don't be afraid to put on all your stuff after landing, because we've got to taxi back and backtrack to the apron, so it takes sort of 10 minutes or so. So there's plenty of time to get dressed and get sorted out.
In the Antarctic Treaty, it's actually due to be re-signed in a few years, 2042. So the hope, obviously, is that it will be re-signed. But every year, all the governments sit around the table and discuss what's best for the Antarctic community. And they really do that. Bo Patrick and I have attended those meetings. And beyond the Antarctic Treaty, there's something called IATO, which is the International Association of Antarctic Tour Operators, which is essentially a group of tourism operators that are competitors that sit around a table and create their own rules by which they're going to be governed, which is also quite an extraordinary and unusual thing. So Antarctica really is self-governing, and the priority always is minimal impact, environmental responsibility, and sustainable tourism. And obviously that's a very difficult thing when you're dealing with the cruise industry, right? As Patrick mentioned, the guesstimate is 120,000 passengers going to Antarctica this year, all in the eastern part of the peninsula. So trying to ensure that they just have a minimal impact on a very small area. And of course there is going to be impact, but it's to minimize that impact. And everybody wants to visit this special place in this great wilderness, but when you've got large numbers, you've got quite large problems. So we're quite lucky in the interior in that last year there were only about 400 people that came to the interior of Antarctica. So we're dealing with very different numbers. But if anyone wants me to talk more about the Antarctic Treaty System and how it all works, I'm happy to pour you to tears about that.
Thanks. Perfectly preserved regions on the planet. Its frozen landscapes are home to many amazing species, each uniquely adapted to its extraordinary climate. Largely untouched and undisturbed, special guidelines exist to ensure it continues to be a constant source of wonder and inspiration. Once you land, following all leader advice allows you to have the safest and best experience possible, while keeping Antarctica pristine. The continent has some of the most severe winds on the planet, so please always secure your belongings to avoid anything being blown away. Inspect the
cliche. to take your seat for arrival. Thank you.
Thank you.
Enjoy, sir.
Bye.
Thank you.
Bye.
It's a bit special.
It's a tiny bit special, right?
Yes, absolutely.
It's just a little bit.